Are you curious? This is Angie Stewart from MIA Inner Light and Kardec Radio. Today we are going to talk about charity and good health. Are they related? Yes, science says they are related. But before we continue, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, MIA Inner Light, and help us to spread the good news. Okay. So, what is charity? Charity is the act of giving something to someone. So, when you have empathy within you, you see someone going through a difficult time or having trouble, you feel the desire of helping, you feel the desire of extending your hand. But what does it have to do with good health? Well, there is a lot of research about it, but I chose one specific doctor to help you to understand it. His name is Dr. Stephen Post. He is a professor, he's a researcher of the University of Stony Brook in New York. He wrote many books in this topic. He started because he works with patients with Alzheimer's, and then he discovered every time someone had the act of goodness, act of charitable love towards the patients, they start connecting with certain things and improving. But not just the patients, the people who visit them too. How? Well, first of all, let me tell you the names of his books. Please research Dr. Stephen Post. And the book that I like the most is Why Good Things Happen to Good People. Then he also wrote The Hidden Gifts of Helping and Unlimited Love. They are all beautiful. I also found a very short video that I will post the link for you guys. The name of the video is Science of Kindness. And in this video shows that the charitable people, they have a boost of energy, a boost in their hormones. And the hormones are serotonin, endorphin, and oxytocin. I was really surprised. And in this short video, it tells that many acts of kindness, goodness, when you practice love, when you help someone, these hormones, they vibrate within you and they help you in many ways. So if you are down, if you're depressed, if you are having all kinds of trouble, suddenly things start changing. And this is physically speaking. But what is the point of spirituality with this? This is a different point of view. But the philosophy that I follow, the Spiritist philosophy, in this book, this is The Gospel According to Spiritism. In chapter 15, we have a chapter talking about the acts of charity. We can even mention St. Paul, because St. Paul wrote a beautiful letter about charity and love. In some translations it's love, in some translations it's charity. And he explains that charity really moves the mountains. And we also have a saying in Spiritism that we say, without charity there is no salvation. Salvation not in the meaning of being saved, but in the meaning of improvement. Without charity, we cannot improve, we cannot progress, we cannot be better. When you are charitable, you get out of your comfort zone to help somebody else. You extend your hand. There are many different types of charity. The most common one is giving alms. You know, you give a little bit of money here, or if you have a good condition, you give a lot of money there. The other very common type of charity is donating things. When you take like shoes, clothes, furniture, and you donate to people or to institutions. For example, in America, Salvation Army. But is this real charity? Yes, it is real charity because you are actually helping others. But what is the real charity? Is when you donate yourself. When you donate yourself to do something. When you get out of your comfort zone and you go there and you act. Because to some people, transfer from your bank account to some kind of charitable cause is good, is easy. But when you actually take your body and you go there and you help in whatever you believe, if it's the cause of the animals, when you go to an animal shelter and you see the difficulties of the people trying to connect the animals with homes, to feed them, to clean them, to keep them comfortable until they are hopefully adopted. This is a super act of charity. But you can do so many other things. You can visit the elderly. I know right now, COVID, yeah, we cannot visit them, but soon we will be able to do it. And so many other things, helping the cause of homeless, helping the planet, whatever you believe, whatever you understand, it's good. This will boost your energy, will boost your serotonin, oxytocin, and all the other hormones they were talking about. So, there is another type of charity that I did not mention, and this is the easiest one or the most difficult one. What is this? When someone, it could be a friend, it could be a coworker, you could be a family member, someone is in trouble and you decide to help. I'm not talking about financially, I'm talking about the real charity. When you just take the phone and you say, "Hi, I heard you're going through a difficult time. I'm here for you. I just would like to tell you that we all go through difficult times, but it shall pass." Whatever you want to tell the person. Because sometimes a word, this phone call will change the life of someone. Will change in so many ways. Yes, it could be that the person that you are trying to talk to is not an easy person. Maybe you even have a hard time with that person and you don't want to do it. But this is exactly what charity is, when you get out of your comfort zone. So when you call the person or when you just meet the person, let's have a coffee, let's talk about it. This person will be so surprised, will be so happy. And another thing, whenever we do something for someone else, you will be receiving back. I'm not talking about the act that you give money to somebody else and that person will pay you. That's not what I'm telling you. I'm telling you when you give love, I'm talking about own experience because I visit nursing homes for many, many years. I work with homeless for many, many years. And these people, they can't give you anything back, but they give their heart. Even if they give just a word, even if they just say thank you. We have to understand that we are not physically alone. We are surrounded by spirits. We are surrounded by good spirits and kind of more or less. But whenever you help someone, the spirits that love this person, these elderly people, these children in orphanage, these homeless people, they will be grateful. And the spirits that love them, they will be grateful too. So whenever we do this, we are receiving double love. I always tell people that come to my, I used to do dance and musical performances in New York. Now I do here in Miami in the nursing homes. So many times the elderly, they can't even clap because they are so sick. And when they finish the performance, we go around them saying, "Thank you for coming. We're so happy." And a lot of them, they have a difficulty expressing in words, but they grab our hands, they press their hands, and just smile. And that transfer of energy is a blessing. So I hope you enjoy. See you soon.